Welcome to the Alexander Kasser Theater. Please turn off cell phones and electronic devices. Photography is not permitted. Please take a moment to note the location of the exits. Thank you for your attention, Jen.
Thanks so much for coming tonight. We are going to start our part of the program with a guest conductor. And this young man graduated from here last year, class of 2021, was in the Wind Symph, was in Symphonic Band, was played in Campus Band for me. He's a terrific, terrific musician, great conductor. Turns out, a really great composer. So he showed me this piece of music, he played it for me, and I said, you have to play this. You have to come and conduct this in Campus Band. So please give a warm welcome to Alan Dalias conducting Together Again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Aren't those fun tunes? I like them. Okay, a couple of things before our last tune. Just a couple of folks I'd like to thank. I'd like to thank Dr. McCauley, who is the director of bands here at Montclair State, for his assistance always with Campus Band. And I want to thank the wonderful performers that are on the stage. They are terrific. We had such a fun semester. Just a couple of things about this band. This is called Campus Band Community Band. So we have folks in here who are music majors, but they're playing on their secondary instruments. And we have folks that, there are a couple of high school students in here, and there are a couple of, a bunch of my friends that are band directors that just came and played. So that's sort of the community band part of it. We rehearse one night a week. So in the fall, if you play an instrument and you want to come and play, Tuesday nights, 6 o'clock, we have a really great time. So thanks, guys. It was a really fun semester. Thank you so much for playing, for all my kooky friends that came back to play. Really appreciate it. There are a lot of Montclair graduates in here, too. Okay, so the last piece was just written. Brian Bell Mages, who's written quite a number of pieces for middle school, high school, some elementary school band pieces, but he has quite a large catalog of pieces that he has written. And you know, with what's been going on in Ukraine, he felt that he needed to write a new piece of music depicting what's going on, unfortunately, over there. A bunch of years ago, he wrote a piece called Moscow, 1941, I think. And this is the partner piece to it. But as soon as I knew he was writing a piece, I got my hands on it. And the other thing that's terrific about this is all of the proceeds, all of the money from the initial release of this piece of music is being donated to Ukrainian relief. And as of about a month ago, I think it was up to 30,000. So there's a lot of band directors that are playing this piece right now. So we're gonna end with that. Thanks so much for coming. And please stay for the second half of the concert. Symphonic Band's gonna be terrific. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Gosh, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Wasn't the campus band really great? Didn't they do a great job? Yeah, they sure did. You know, it's a real pleasure. It's a real pleasure to work here, and it's a real pleasure to work with these students. You know, I was telling them earlier that I don't know that I've ever, I mean, I've been teaching for longer than I absolutely want to admit. And I don't know in all my time I've ever worked with a group that has come such a long way in such a short period of time. Folks have been just amazing to work with all year long. Absolutely amazing. Yes, it's true. I told them earlier, but I want to say it publicly. So the next piece, it's really cool. We had a chance here in the band program to be a part of a commissioning consortium of about, I don't know, 20 schools or something that all sort of contributed to have this next piece written. And one of the reasons why we wanted to be a big part of it is because of who the composer is. Allison Loggins Hall is on our faculty here. She's an amazing flute teacher, but she's also an amazing performer, an amazing flutist, and a great composer. And I'm so happy that she was asked to do this piece. This is in sort of flex instrumentation, what they're calling it now, and it's just sort of like parts that can be played by multiple instruments, like, you know, at any time. That has been very helpful, as you might imagine, over the last couple of years with all the comings and goings and all of that business. And we were just so thrilled to be able to do this, and with Allison here on our faculty, and she zoomed into one of our rehearsals the other day, and she was so cool. She came here to our sound check this afternoon and is actually here tonight with us. It's so great. And so I asked her if she would mind coming up and just saying a few words about the piece, and she said she would. So please welcome to the stage Allison Loggins Hall.
Thank you, Dr. McCauley. Thank you, students, for performing my piece, programming it tonight. I'm going to try to be as concise as possible, which is not a strength of mine, but just give kind of a little overview of the inspiration behind the piece. And I'm so glad you explained the flex concept, because I was like, oh gosh, am I gonna have to explain that? Because it was new to me when I embarked on this journey. So anyway, the piece, it's called The Loop, for flex band electronics, and it's inspired by the city of Chicago and some histories relating to the city of Chicago. Chicago is a city that I hold very near and dear to my heart. I'm a native Chicagoan. My entire family is from Chicago. It's one of my favorite cities in the world. And this piece actually premiered at the Midwest Clinic, which is this annual conference for music educators, music students, performers that's held in Chicago. So it felt very fitting to celebrate this, the Windy City that I love so, so much. And one of the stories that I decided to kind of hone in on was very much inspired by my grandparents, who are from rural Mississippi. And they were part of the Great Migration, which occurred in the first half of the 20th century, and is basically the journey of hundreds of thousands of African Americans who escaped the South, escaped Jim Crow South, and headed north to northern cities for greater opportunities, essentially. And that is my grandparents' story. And I wanted to, in the piece, capture the spirit of perseverance, of positive outlook, of you know, working hard towards a goal and in the hopes of a better life and of achievement, and being in a new city and a new place and the excitement of that. And I also just kind of really, really embodying the idea of Chicago, wanted to incorporate some Chicago musical styles. So you'll hear in the track especially a nod to house music, which is not really known to be used in concert band music, but I thought, hey, why not? Okay, here we go. so you'll hear that, which I think is fun. And it's called The Loop. There's a little play on that too. If you're familiar with Chicago, the transit system has an above-ground train, and when you're in downtown Chicago, it loops around the city, and so everybody in Chicago calls it The Loop. And in terms of music, I used loops in the piece, which is a technique that's often used in popular music, but also and minimalism and other genres where you have material that's repeated throughout. And I thought that also would help embody the idea of perseverance and ongoing. So I'm gonna stop there. Did I do okay? Was that like? I'm working on that. So thanks again, guys, and I hope you all enjoy.
Thank you.
Thanks again, and thanks for coming. Appreciate it. We have one last thing to do, and what we discovered when we were working on Allison's piece was that they play a lot better without me. And so we thought we would just finish up the concert that way too. I get paid to do the same way. It's fine. We're going to close with a piece by Sam Hazo called Ride. And honestly, we were like, well, what do you think? Do you think we could do this like by ourselves? And it's a really cool thing to do because it really takes away the visual part. It forces everyone to really tune into like everybody else in the group, and that's what you really want in an ensemble anyway. So we're going to close with Sam Hazo's Ride, and thanks a lot very much, and hopefully we'll see you again sometime.